Hi, Spinthusiast. Today, I'm going to talk to you about a topic that is very near and dear to my heart, sunscreen. If you're about to go into band camp for the next couple of weeks, or if you have been outside all summer and you're just going to be outside more and you've already been exposed to the sun, you still need to use sunscreen. Even if you're not getting burned necessarily, you're still being exposed to harmful ultraviolet radiation from the sun. And you might even say, oh, well, my parents, my grandparents, whatever, were farmers and they were exposed to so much more than I've ever been exposed to and they haven't gotten skin cancer. They had an ozone layer when they were your age. We don't anymore. So here is some of the products that I use and some tips for how to use sunscreen. First of all, I have this lovely face lotion. This is actually Olay wrinkle fighting lotion. It's like a daily lotion. It has SPF 15 in it and it just does a good job. It goes on easy and it dries very quickly. If I know I'm going to be out in the sun for a really long time, like say at band camp, I use this Hawaiian Tropic Weightless Face. This is SPF 30, so it basically cuts the amount of sun's rays that can get to my face by a lot. So awesome. My husband really likes this one, Neutrogena Men. It also, not only is it SPF 20, it also cuts the sting of like razor burn. So I use it on my legs sometimes. If I have razor burn, I'm gonna go out. But the only thing is it's a lot more like a lotion than these last two. These last two, you can kind of rub in and they'll dry. This one kind of stays on your skin like a lotion does. So keep that in mind if you're thinking about using that. This is dog sunscreen. It's called EpiPet. So if you have a dog with really short hair or really light colored hair, put sunscreen on them before they go outside. Not that you should be taking your dog to band camp, but I mean, who knows what you guys do at your band. This is one of my favorites, Hawaiian Tropic. This one is only SPF 15, so I don't stay out in the sun very long with it, and I reapply it a lot when I'm wearing it. I use this usually toward the end of the summer whenever I am already fairly tan and I've already been exposed quite a bit and my skin can kind of handle itself a little bit better. So this is good stuff. It's also weightless. I love sunscreen sprays so much more. I hate rubbing lotion on my skin, especially if I'm sweaty. This is Equate Sport. It is the Walmart brand of sunscreen. It is SPF 50. I don't really like going this high, but it was one of those things where I was on the road and I needed to grab some sunscreen really quick because I forgot to buy it ahead of time. And so grabbed this stuff. It is really thick. It sprays on really thick. So if you're very, very pale, this would be awesome for protecting you from the sun. You're basically almost not gonna tan through this. You'll still tan a little, you'll still freckle a little bit, but it's not gonna be anywhere near as much as with a lower SPF. This is one of my favorites. It is Neutrogena Cool Dry Sport. It is water resistant, it is sweat resistant, it's SPF 30, and this does a great job. At the beginning of the summer, this is an empty can, you can hear it. But at the beginning of the summer, I buy a whole bunch of this and I usually go through a can of sunscreen every week and a half of band camps, color guard camps. So you should be putting on lots of sunscreen. So this is probably my favorite for camps and I love to use it. My other favorite that I don't have a can of because they've stopped selling it locally is Bullfrog Mosquito Coast. I really hate putting on both sunscreen and bug spray, so Bullfrog Mosquito Coast is both of them combined, and it does a really good job of keeping the mosquitoes off. I don't know if you are like me, but I have a blood type that mosquitoes love, and I also eat too much sugar, and I also do not eat enough things like onions and garlic in my life, so mosquitoes just absolutely love me. My husband loves taking me on hiking trips because basically the mosquitoes never even touch him, and they come and attack me. When you are looking for a sunscreen, whether you like the more thick lotiony kind or you like the more thin, dry, lightweight kind, that doesn't matter nearly as much as the SPF. Generally, you want to keep to about SPF 30. That's your best bet for protecting you as much as you can possibly be protected. 50 is still pretty good. If you get any higher than 50, you're probably not actually getting the protection that you think you're getting. If you go to the Skin Cancer Foundation, and I'll put a link to the article in the description, but the Skin Cancer Foundation actually has done a lot of research into sunscreens and how much SPF matters. Basically, if you go over 50, it's really not gonna do much of anything. You actually might be harming your skin more and letting more sun's rays through if you're going over 50. But generally 30 is a good level to be at to protect yourself and still get a tan. You can go down a little bit, go down to 15. I wouldn't go any lower than that. I know there are some people who use less than that, but also remember, if you're going down to a 15, you need to reapply even more. So that's it for today, guys. Let me know if you have any other sunscreens that you love in the comment section below. And what do you use? What do you like about it? What do you not like about it? And maybe I will do another review and let you guys know about some more sunscreen. Because like I said, this is a really important topic to me. You want to stay healthy. You don't want skin cancer when you're older. Make sure you like this video. Share it with all your friends. ColorGuard is so much better if your entire team is not sunburned.